I've been working since 1999 as an assistant professor in physics. I completed my MSc in 1994 and then I joined for research under the guideship of Professor B.S. Shah. From 1994 to 1998, I have done my PhD in material science. My topic was new hardness and isotropy in organic molecular solids. I also won a CSIR research scholarship in 1997. That was a senior research fellowship for 2 years, which I completed in 99. So I come from a family of doctors, but just after my graduation, I joined a school and I was teaching a lower standard there, and this made me very interested in the teaching job. So I wanted to continue as a teacher in my life. While teaching the smaller classes students, I learned that I love the teaching and I love my students also, and it gave me an opportunity to study further and teach the higher class students. So I have been given the opportunity of being the class teacher of first year BSc students since I joined the college, and my work is to guide the students into the ways of the college and motivate them to participate in the various activities of the college. Earlier, I was the member of the science club where we organized poster and oral presentation competitions, science quiz, essay writing competitions and many others. Then I was made the coordinator of the faculty development program of the college, in which many programs I had arranged. One was the yoga workshop. Another remarkable one was the body language seminar, which I arranged, and there were many more during that year. After that, I have been given the responsibility of handling the grievance redressal cell of the Christ College. I have been the coordinator since the past many years. Since 2007, I have been made a member of the examination committee. As a part of my duty, we conduct all the college exams, the university exams, then prelim exams and exams of other institutes like the Railway Recruitment Board, the PGVCL exam, the DOEC exam, etc. I have been made the member of the publication committee. In that, we coordinate the publication of the materials related to the college, like the brochure, which highlights the activities of the past year conducted by the college, and this will give an idea to the new students what all they can expect from the college. Plus, we go for publications like the handbook, the syllabus book, the yearly calendar and other informative material. I have been teaching physics in the department since the past 17 years. Experience has taught me to point out the weaker and the academically good students. We motivate all the types of students to participate in all the activities, and we take special care of the weak students so that they also come out and they can stand in line with the stronger students. We give them extra support by taking extra classes whenever needed, and especially in this region of Gujarat, mostly we have students from the Gujarati medium who have a very great difficulty in understanding of English. So in the beginning of the year, I teach in both the languages, Gujarati as well as English, so that they understand the physics part and they also learn the English part of the physics. Later on, we teach only in English so that they can write the exams in a confident way. We also make them to participate in various activities like essay writing and paper presentation, and I take class seminars also. In the physics department, I have started a physics wall magazine wherein I and my students put up articles of interest in physics, and all of the students are very happy to contribute weekly to the physics wall magazine. I am in contact with almost all the alumni of the department, and many of the students keep in touch via email if they are abroad, and if they are here, they can come here and meet us always. And we always have interactions with the alumni of the present students. we find that the students can interact more easily with the alumni and they can ask about the career options and other options available for higher studies when they interact with the alumni. This helps the current students in a great way. The IAPT annually organizes the National Graduate Physics Exam, in which I motivate our students to participate each year. Also, the Gujarat Science Academy conducts the Meenakshi Lalit Science Award test for various subjects of science, in which we motivate maximum number of science students to participate, and many have won laurels in those exams. In addition, I always motivate my students to participate in all types of activities which are conducted by other institutions also. Like the Gujarat Science Academy is conducting the Science Excellence program since the last 3-4 years. So my students have been regularly participating in them. The IAPT is conducting the Student Science Symposium at Chandigarh since the last 3 years. And again, I motivate my students to participate and many have presented papers therein. The Physics Teaching and Talent Search program was conducted at Kuvempu University, Karnataka last year, where one of our students got an opportunity to participate. Also, the Advanced BSc Physics summer program is held at St. Xavier's College in collaboration with the institutes like the Institute of Plasma Research, Gandhinagar, the Physical Research Laboratory at Ahmedabad, and of course the St. Xavier's Institute. And every year, my second year students go for this vacation program. They learn a lot from these training programs and they are motivated to take up physics as a subject of higher studies. In addition to the college, I am a member of the managing committee of the Regional Community Science Center at Rajkot. As a part of the convener of the physics study circle at the Community Science Center, we have conducted many programs like oral and poster presentation competition and physics quiz, etc. And my students always participate in Messier marathons, which are held every year at the Community Science Center. Plus, they go for electronics workshop at the Community Science Center. Also, the Community Science Center arranges the sky watching program here for our students at the college. The Community Science Center also publishes a wall magazine, the Science Wall magazine called as Vignan Jagrut, which is circulated to 3,000 schools around Gujarat. I write articles in them about physics and about general science for the level of very small students, and I encourage my students also to write small articles in the magazine. In addition, the IAPT Gujarat chapter has been publishing the Pragami Tarang magazine since 2011, and I have always written articles since 2011 in them. Also, I have encouraged my students to write articles in them, and some of my students have gotten their articles published in these magazines. In addition, the Department of Atomic Energy always conducts a national level essay writing competition in nuclear science and technology, and I always encourage my students to write the essays for them. One of my students got a third prize, and more than that, she got an opportunity to visit BARC, and right now she is doing research in the field of plasma physics. I teach the first, second and third year BSc students. My main subjects are electronics, nuclear physics and space physics, and I teach generally modern physics to first year students. I am also in charge of the practicals for the first year students. I have published 2 manuals for the first year BSc students according to the syllabus of the Saurashtra University. Plus, we have published books of the semester 1, 2, 3 and 4 according to the syllabus of the Saurashtra University, which is done in a very easy language because we have most of the students coming from Gujarati medium for whom the reference books in English are very tough to read and understand. In the college, it is not only physics that I stress my students on learning. I encourage them to take parts in sports, in the activities of the Cultural Club, the Nature Club, the Rotaract Club, NCC and the Science Club. Many of my students are members of the Women's Cell. The Women's Cell of the Christ College organizes various programs for the village women around Rajkot. I encourage all my students to participate in these programs for community service. And I was also invited to give a lecture on the importance of International Women's Day in 2010 as a part of this program.
The Indira Gandhi National Open University broadcasts a radio program called Gyanvani. I was invited for delivering 30-minute lectures on various topics of physics. 13 talks of mine have been broadcast under the program. Also, I was invited as an expert in a program by Doordarshan.
Collect as many
moderately low. So these are the basics of the terminals, emitter, base and collector. So today we are going to learn about the construction of the BJT, its working. Then there are some rules for connecting, which I call them as golden rules. And then we'll take the case of common emitter configuration. Okay. So in the construction, you have the emitter, the base and the collector. Taking the case of NPN transistor, the majority charge carriers are electrons in N-type, and in P-type majority charge carriers are holes. There will be a few minority charge carriers here. How the NPN or PNP transistor can be constructed? The three terminals are taken out. One is emitter, another is base, another is collector. You have two junctions. Junction is a place where these two meet, two regions meet. So first junction is the emitter base junction. The second one is the collector base junction. So you have two junctions and three terminals. Three terminals are emitter, base and collector, and two junctions, emitter base junction and collector base junction. Now for the working, we need to know the golden rules. And yes, Javi?
Emitter base junctions are always forward bias and collector base junctions are always reverse bias.
So there are two golden rules for connecting. One is always reverse biased. Now why these rules have to be followed for the working of a transistor? So what is so special about these rules? Now what do we mean by forward bias?
Positive, negative to negative means forward bias.
So don't say positive to positive, it is P-type to positive and N-type to negative. That is forward bias. P-type to negative and N-type to positive is reverse biased. Now why we need to make the emitter base junction forward biased? So for forward bias, this is N-type, we connect to the negative of the battery. For reverse bias, we connect this to the positive of the battery. This battery we call as VBE, this we call as VCE. Now why we have to give forward bias to the emitter base junction is, the charge carriers have to go from the emitter towards the connector. Towards the collector. For them, they need some push. Here, because of the junction, there is a depletion layer. Again, there is another depletion layer to cross. So that when you connect negative to the N-type, the charge carriers will move from the emitter towards the collector. Okay, they will get a push and they will move towards the collector. When you reverse bias the base, then this positive of the battery will pull all the charge carriers from the collector. That means the charge carriers can move from emitter to collector. A small animation on how the transistor works when you are applying the forward bias to the emitter base and reverse bias to the collector base. Now here, this emitter base junction is connected to the battery VBE and the collector emitter is connected to the VCE battery. Okay? This is the common emitter configuration. Now here, the VBE voltage right now is 0 volt. Okay? And VCE is not given. So right now, nothing is given, no VBE, no VCE. Then there are no charge carriers. You can see that there are two depletion layers. One is here, one is here at the two junctions. One is the emitter base junction, another is the collector base junction. Okay. There are two depletion layers, the line shown by white around that red. red part is the base. Okay. So that is the lightly doped p-type base, the red part. Now you are applying only the battery BCE, not right now applying the battery BBE. At that time what happens? BCE means the collector base is reverse biased by the BCE battery. You are applying the reverse bias. Okay. Now when there is current, the charge carriers will move from emitter to collector. But here you can see that on applying the BCE, they are not going from the emitter to collector, because we have not applied any forward bias to the emitter base junction. Only the reverse bias is applied. The charge carriers remain in the emitter junction, they remain in the collector region, and they cannot cross the junctions. Okay? So right now they are not applying. Now here we are slowly increasing the value of BBE. But you should give a minimum amount of BBE. In transistor biasing you have learned that minimum BBE and minimum BCE you should apply. If it is very less, that is 0.6 volt only, then for 0.6 volts, the charge carriers will be there in the emitter junction, but they will not get enough energy to cross the depletion layer. Base emitter is forward biased, but it is not properly forward biased. Therefore, they remain in the emitter junction. But now you keep on increasing the BBE even further. Now you can see that they can freely cross the junction. They get enough voltage, cross the junction and go towards the collector. Now here, this shows the base current which is flowing, and that is the collector current. Now if you keep on increasing the base emitter voltage, that means you are increasing the forward bias on the base emitter junction, then the base current will increase and the collector current will increase even more. You can see that many charge carriers are passing from the collector, that is known as collector current, and base current is increasing but a little bit. So as base current keeps on increasing, collector current increases even further. This is known as amplification. As you keep on increasing the voltage, minimum BBE is 0.7 volt for silicon transistors. When you are giving that, you get the maximum increase in collector current.